2021 marks the 30-year anniversary of the Wiggles, and while Anthony is the only one left of the original Wiggles, following the retirement of Greg, Murray, and Jeff at the end of 2012, Emma, Simon, and Lockie have picked it up and, along with Anthony, are continuing on as the current Wiggles. However, there is actually a fifth Wiggle early on that many people are not aware of. And no, it's not Captain Feathersword. Now let's start by going back to 1991 when the Wiggles were first created. And Anthony Field, the original and current Blue Wiggle, played a large role in starting up the Wiggles. Now he contacted people he either knew through university or through being in a band with. These people would be Greg Page, who would be the original Yellow Wiggle, Murray Cook, who would be the original Red Wiggle, and Jeff Fatt, who would be the original Purple Wiggle. However, the fifth Wiggle is Philip Wilcher, a person he knew through university who was a teacher at the time Anthony was a student. And Philip was brought in and actually contributed heavily to the debut album, writing about 75% of the music. And I'd highly recommend, if you look up on YouTube, you can actually find that debut album. I'd highly recommend listening to it, because while there are a few songs that you do recognize that they kept, a lot of the songs, that was the only time they ever had them in the Wiggles, and they sound very much like Wiggles music, but you know, you never hear them because they were in the debut album, and I'll get more to what happened with that later on. Now, Philip had plans for more than just the debut album of the Wiggles. He was trying to get an ABC contract for the Wiggles and was helping with that for future albums. He had planned to be a continued writer for future Wiggles albums, and whether that means him just focusing on the writing or still being one of the five Wiggles, I think either or would have worked for him. But what ended up happening instead was the Wiggles wrote and created a second album without the help of Philip, and ultimately he ended up resigning in part because of that. Philip quickly disappeared from the Wiggles world after that debut album. That debut album was actually almost double platinum when in 1998 they decided to re-record it and remove all contributions Philip had to that debut album. So pretty quickly after that, the royalty checks he would receive were next to nothing, and I'm sure in 2021 it's been quite some time since he's truly had a royalty check. Now, why is it that Philip is no longer with the Wiggles? I think it's hard to say the exact reason that Philip didn't do anything with the Wiggles following the debut album. A Wiggles spokesperson said that Philip submitted the letter of resignation because he wanted to continue composing classical music. Apparently, Philip had said the reason he left was because he wasn't comfortable performing with the Wiggles, but I don't really believe that, because he had done a lot of legwork behind the scene to get the Wiggles rolling and do more beyond the debut album, and even if he didn't want to perform with them, he could at least be in the background and write music, which is what he really enjoyed to do. I think the only person that truly knows the answer to why Philip didn't do anything beyond the debut album is Anthony Field, as he was the one that really got the Wiggles going in the early days, and ultimately was the one that informed Philip that they recorded their second album without him. And I doubt we'll ever hear from Anthony what the exact reason is that Philip didn't do anything after the debut album. Beyond his short tenure with the Wiggles, Philip's had a successful music career. At the age of 14, he published his first piano composition, Daybreak, which at the time made him the youngest published composer in Australia. And his time after the Wiggles, he continued to write music, wrote books. In fact, I own Flowers and Flight, poems from a child's perspective. So he continued to have a career in music and with the children's work as well. With 2021 marking the 30-year anniversary of the Wiggles and neither Sam or Philip being brought back to celebrate that, I doubt we're going to see either of them come back anytime soon. However, when we look back to 1991 and Philip, I wonder what could have been. If he stayed in the group, part of me thinks he'd at least stay till most of the original Wiggles left at the end of 2012, but maybe he'd still be a Wiggle to this day. Who knows? But the other big question is, if he did stay with the Wiggles, what color skivvy would he have? Let me know what you think in the comments. I think my guess would be orange. I think that one makes the most sense for what the Wiggles are going for, but it definitely makes you wonder what could have been if Philip stuck around. So there we have it, Philip, the fifth Wiggle, who was only around for that debut album in 1991. Now, this is the first Wiggles content I've made on my channel. The Wiggles have always held a special place in my heart, so if you enjoyed it, please let me know in the comment section below. I'd love to make more content like this if people enjoy it. Anyway, thank you everyone for watching. This is Percy number 6. Have a great day.